up your name, God, to thank you, my God and my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I worship you. God, I thank you. Father, we honor you. Lord, we come to you in the mighty name of Jesus. You are our Father. We worship you this morning, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We are come to fellowship with you, God. Fellowship with you, God, my Father. Joy in the fellowship. There is joy in the fellowship of God. There is joy in the fellowship. God, every discouragement, every frustration, I reject you. Disappointment, I reject you. Frustration, I reject you. Discomfort, I reject you. My God and my Father, I thank you. I thank you for this fellowship this morning. The joy of God. There is a joy of God in the fellowship. Lord, I want to thank you. I want to thank you. I want to bless you, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to welcome everyone who have joined us. First timers, I welcome you once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. Welcome once again. I want to ask if you are not one of us, get out of the scope, because you are going to be disappointed. We are spiritual warfare, and I might talk things that you don't like. That's why I want to ask you to get out of Periscope, because you don't belong there. Any child of the devil, child of darkness, you don't need to share or to say anything. Just get out and you will be okay. But if you continue speaking or writing some evil, some stuff, then the curse of God will fall upon you and you will not escape. You better get out of the Periscope and it shall be well with you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Once again, welcome. Yesterday, I was like, I have to give myself a break to do my private prayer. But the Holy Spirit today woke me 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock, I said, I am going to take off this week. But the Holy Spirit forced me, told me, go. And then I said, what am I going to share? Because I'm not prepared. Said, Christine, you have so much. You have a lot to share. Go. I want you to share the early in the morning this much. You haven't shared anything about the early in the morning. So I said, give me the subject. Give me the title. Then God gave me this title. God supports and protects early in the morning from attacks. God supports and protects early in the morning. There is power in the morning. That God Almighty protect us. And God supports us. God support us and protect us from early in the morning from attacks. When we do things, when we go, wherever we are doing, anything we are doing, God supporting us and protect us. And it is early in the morning that we have to go. It is early in the morning. Your time, I don't know, but here is early in the morning. So wherever you plan to do anything, plan when you go early in the morning, God will protect you. God will support your work. God will protect you in the morning from the attacks. Any attacks that has been prepared to attack you in the morning, God will protect you. God will honor you. God will support you in the name of Jesus. Therefore, people of God, I want to pray that anything that is planned to attack you this morning or this hour, the Lord Almighty will destroy them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, God. I want to bless your name, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God, you are wonderful. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come against any attacks. Attacks that has been prepared by the enemy. I command them to die. I crush them in Jesus' name. This morning, this day, this month, in the name of Jesus, I come against every attacks from the enemy. Because God is protecting us. God is supporting us. Therefore, anything that we are doing, God is supporting us. God is protecting us. There will be no attacks of the enemy. Any attacks from the enemy shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. We are going to attack the camps of the enemy. We are going to surround the camp of the enemy and attack the enemy, because God is going to protect us in the mighty name of Jesus. You do not fear. Face the enemy. Surround the enemy. Attack. And God is going to protect you and support you in Jesus' name. Things you have been fear a lot, you are not going to fear anymore. This hour, this morning, when you wake up, things you have not been doing before because you have fear, go and attack them. God will protect you, and God will protect you from an attack. You are the one to go and attack the enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. You will attack the enemies. The enemies will not have any power against you. The enemies will not have any power over you because God will support you and God will protect you. If you are doing anything of God, if you are doing the right thing, if you are doing the right thing, there is protection, there is support. God will support you and protect you in the name of Jesus. Let's look in the book of Joshua. God supports and protects his pharaohs. Here he promised to serve our as our rear guide to protect us from attacks where we are most vulnerable. In the book of Joshua, Joshua 6, verse 12 to 15. Joshua 6, verse 12 to 15. The Bible says, early in the morning, the priest took up the ark of the Lord. Early in the morning, the priest took the ark of the Lord. The seven priests, bearing seven trumpets of rams, horns, before the ark of the Lord, went on continually and blow with the trumpets, and the armed men went before them. But the layer guide came after the ark of the Lord. While the priests continually blowing the trumpets, and the second day they marched around the city once and returned to the camp. So they did 6 days. But it came to pass on the seventh day that they lost Ari about the drawing of the day and marched around the city 7 times in the same manner. On that day, only they marched around the city 7 times, and the city fell down. The wall of Jericho fell down. So as you are going to march around your enemies, as going to attack your enemies, you know, the children of Israel, the priests, they were in the midst of the enemies. They went to attack the enemies early in the morning. They blowing the trumpet. You know, when they were blowing the trumpet sound so loud, but they were not discouraged. They continued surrounding the place and rounding the place with the ark of God, with the blessings and prayers and everything. It was early in the morning. God there cried, protected them. The layer guide protect them. God protected them. God protected them. Nothing happened to them. God protected them. God support them, protect them early in the morning from the attacks. God was protecting them. So when they were surrounding, you know, they went to the wall of Jericho. When they surrounding that wall, they march. This is a march. This is the month of March. So you will march to the wall of your enemies and surround that enemy and blow the trumpet through spirit, in the spiritual realm. You will attack the enemy. You will watch and imagine you, that enemy, attacking me, the enemy that has been assigned against my life and my family. I am coming to attack you. You will attack them by prayer and fasting. You will attack by surrounding your prayer, surrounding the wall of fire, surrounding the holes, surrounding the wall of fire around you in the name of Jesus. You will attack the enemy when you are surrounding the wall of fire around you, when you are surrounding the blood of Jesus, when you build the blood of Jesus around you in Jesus' name. This Jericho, the priest, when they was surrounding, going round, marching round and blowing the trumpet, what happened? The wall of Jericho fall down. Any wall of Jericho built by the enemy shall fall down in the name of Jesus. Any strong enemy that is standing against you, as you are as this hour, this hour is morning here. But in your country, I don't know your hours. In my country, it will be evening. But some of you, it would be evening. Yes, it should be evening or night. I don't know. But all in all, is the time that you surround yourself with prayers. You surround yourself with these prayers. You build a wall of prayers. Now, when you build a wall of prayers, no enemy will come to attack you because God will protect you and support you. This is what happened. Now, when this was physical, when they went there with the trumpet and surrounding trumpet and surrounding marching the place loud. We are marching to march or march. We are marching to march. We are still march. Now, every enemy building against you, every enemy standing against you, they shall fall down in the name of Jesus. Early in the morning, when you decide to fellowship with God, David was in the wilderness. David was isolated outside, and he went to pray and he fellowship with God early in the morning. There is power when you isolate yourself and to pray, to talk to God. And then anything planned against you, you have to separate yourself and talk to God. Even Jesus, there was a time he separated himself and he went early in the morning to pray and speak to God. You can choose the time, the best time that you can go and have your altar and pray. You can go, you can build an altar anywhere where you can be isolated, you can be yourself and pray. Or you can be go with that team. You can organize yourself with that team. A team of the people who have faith with you, they can stand and pray. We did our 21 days prayer and fasting. One sister, she was following me. She never missed even one day. Even if I know she tried all the days, even sometimes when people are getting really tired, she's there. She's always number one, exactly the time she's there. And we have a powerful conversion. We confess, you shall prosper, nothing by all means shall make you poor. She was confessing, and this woman, she has a bad credit. She can't buy anything with her credit because of what she went through, and her credit is not good. Now she was trusting to buy a car. To buy a car, you must have a credit card or a cash. She prayed through 21 days, praying, following us every day. We were doing midnight. The woman of God, she was following this prayer 21 days. And the way I was saying, she was saying, amen, that is me, amen, amen. What happened? God opened a door for her, released financial miracle, cash, and she was able to buy a new car, cash, without straining. She had a new car. God provided money for her, and she was able to buy a new car. And she was giving a testimony last night on our radio. You can go there and hear a testimony by your own ears. That's what she gave last night. We have a radio, Overcomers DH Radio. You go there, there's prayers that you, it is not in YouTube, it's not on a website, but they are on the radio. So you can go and hear a testimony there. I'm telling you, when you follow this prayer, it will work for you very well. This prayer, they are for you. Today, this morning, this hour, as I come to this prayer, I know somebody. God is going to talk to somebody. God is going to touch somebody in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I know that God is going to touch somebody. I was not able, I didn't want to come to pray this morning. But God, you are God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. Lord, I want to praise your name. I give you all the glory. This morning, this prayer, it is going to bless you. It's going to touch your heart. God is going to speak to you. God is going to touch your heart. As you march, as you stand up to march and attack your enemies, go to the enemies, the strongest enemies. Don't be afraid. God is protecting you. God is supporting you. Just pray, believe, and don't be discouraged. Don't be frustrated. Don't give up. Don't give up. Yes, human beings, sometimes you feel like you don't want to do it. You don't want to. You feel so discouraged. You want to give up. Don't give up. Continue. You know, the children of Israel, they were almost to give up, but they encouraged themselves. They said, we are facing the enemy. What are we going to do? God will protect us. God will support us. Let's go and march in the midst of the camp, in the camp of the enemy. And they march there and blow the trumpet. They march 6 days nonstop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, they didn't know how many times they would march, but they continue marching. They never give up. So you will continue hammer the problem that you are facing. If it is financial problem you are facing, try to hammer them. Try to march every day. Try to go to the place where you need to pray. Try to repeat it 100 times. Jesus repeated the prayer so many times until he prayed until he started bleeding the blood, and the blood was, he sweat the blood from, the blood started coming from his body. And that is how serious he was. When you go to pray, you must go by seriously that you are going to pray for something that you need. You will speak to God. You don't have to be. Sometimes you might be feel like you have been praying so many times. You have been praying a lot. You are tired. Sometimes you feel so tired and discouragement and discouraged. That is the time you push on. That is the time you continue moving on. The children of Israel. The first day nothing happened. The second day nothing happened. The third day nothing happened. The 50th day, until the 7th day something happened. You can be praying. You have been trusting God for something. Now you feel like, I am tired. I've been praying years and years. I am so tired. Nothing is happening. Yes, you are tired. When you are tired, like you feel like you want to give up, that's when God is going to show up. God is going to support you. God is going to protect you. God is going to protect you as you wake up early in the morning from an attack that is being prepared from you. God is going to protect you. You feel so tired. You feel so angry. You feel so you sometimes you feel very angry. You wake up in the morning, you feel like you want to fight everybody. You feel really angry. Nobody has talked to you. People called me here with that anger. They feel like I am the one who is telling God not to help them, or I'm responsible for their problem. They started talking to me very rude, and I said, "Yes, I understand well what you are going through, but listen, you come down and we will pray God." And then they would tell me they have prayed so many prayers. A prophet has prayed for them. They have given their tithe and offering. They have done this. Nothing is happening to them. I said, okay. So if nothing has happened to them, so what do you want? Why do you call me and you know nothing is happening to you? Why do you call me if you know nothing is happening to you? So what do you want? Or do you think I'm God? Am I God? Yeah. So I'm the same like you. Now, when you are rich, that I understand you. Understand that problem. You need backup. You need to continue. Even the children of Israel, they could have given up. They could have given up. When they was alone, early in the morning, they were not doing in the midday or whatever, but it was early in the morning when people are sleeping. Then they were early in the morning and surrounding the camp of the enemy. They surrounding, they pray, they blow the trumpet until the 7th day. It is when the wall of Jericho fall down. So you might be feel like so tired, but that is the time you don't have to give up. You push on. You don't have to be backslider because you God has not answered your prayers. Another one is Daniel. When Daniel started praying, his prayers was answered the first day, but the power of Persia, the king of Persia, the whole his prayers for 21 days. So David, Daniel, he didn't give up. He continued praying and repenting and asking God and continued. So 21 days is a lot. It's a lot. But God answered his prayers. Your 21 days can be years, can be months, can be days. But God is going to answer you. You don't have to give up. God is going to help you. God is going to protect you. God is going to support you. Through when you don't have to backslide or give up, God is going to support you. God is going to help you. God's support will stand forever. But the support of the devil will support you today, and tomorrow is taking everything that he gave to you. So the support of God is permanent. Therefore, people of God, don't give up. Don't be discouraged. Look at the book of Psalm 63, verse 1. David, He was in the wilderness where the enemy was chasing him. He was like, he said, God, what is this? What can I do? But he covered himself. He said, this is the time I'm going to fellowship with God. I know there's a joy in the fellowship of God early in the morning. So early in the morning, David decided to fellowship with God. When you wake up early in the morning, you feel so discouraged. You want to give up. You want to, you feel bad about yourself because nothing is happening. Try to have fellowship with God. Try to call God. God, let us have fellowship with you. I know it is you who can help me. I need your support. I need your protection in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the enemy has been attacking your mind. Now the Lord will protect you from attacks. From every attack, that attacks has been attacking you, the Lord will protect you. The Lord will support you, and you will be able to start praying, and you will be able to pray. God will support you. God will give you the Holy Spirit. God will empower you. God will give you strength. Do you know sometimes you have no strength? You have no strength even to pronounce, even to pray. You are tired. You are so discouraged. You can't even open the mouth. I was praying to one person from Germany. She told me that I cannot even pray. I can't open my mouth. There's no word that would come from my mouth. I am fed up. I'm so tired. I'm giving up. So I said, you give up from what? Why are you giving up? I've been praying, sister. I've been praying, Mama Christine. I've been done everything. I have given so much now. I think I'm done. I told her, that's a liar. You have been attacked. But God is going to destroy that attack. God is going to support you and protect you. I told the woman, God is going to support you and protect you. Right now, let me pray for you. God is going to give you strength. God is going to give you strength. God is going to protect you. Yes, it is God. It is God who can help you. What you want to do right now, you are giving yourself to the enemy, and that is what the enemy wants. After you give yourself to the enemy will destroy you, and that is what he wants to do. Keep on. Keep on. Yes, things are the way they are. Things are not good for now, but God Almighty has not abandoned you. Delay is not a denial. God has not denied that he's not going to help you. He knows why the delay is so long, is taking so long. He knows. You are not the only one. You look at the children of Israel in the when they was around that Jericho, the war of Jericho. When they were rounding that place, it's not you alone. Look at Daniel, how he prayed. Moses prayed 40 days, 80 days. Jesus prayed 40 days. 40 days prayer and fasting. Yeah? It takes time. You have to sacrifice yourself to pray and resisting and continually resisting the devil. The Bible says, resist him, he will fly away. Build a wall of prayer. Protect yourself. Drink the blood of Jesus. Call fellowship. Call prayers. Go to the fellowship. Go to the prayer meeting. Call the fellowship. You might not be able to pray, yes, but call fellowship. Look at the videos. Go to the website and choose the prayers that you want to listen. Sometimes, even me, I'm a human being like anybody else. Sometimes I feel like there's nothing I'm going to do. There's nothing I will do it. But I know when you are weak, the Spirit of God will empower you, will come and help you. So I said, my God, I've reached a point where I'm so dry. I need you. I need you. Hallelujah. I need you. You know, some people, when I pray with them, people, they train me. They train my energy. Even some people, they chant right now. They are appointing me, chanting. They train my energy so much. But God protect me, help me, and protect me from attacks. That's how I'm surviving. It's not easy. When, like this month, the whole month, I did 21 days straight away. Evening and morning, straight away, non-stop. I did not stop even one day. 2 meetings, and it's all deliverance. And also, I pray for people who are calling me for deliverance, for prayer. I never give up. It is training. I was trained like I don't have energy, but God protected me and helped me and strengthened me and gave me more energy. I pray that God Almighty will protect you, will support you, and from an attack in the morning, an attack that will come to attack you. Any attack that has been assigned to attack you during the day, during the night, during the morning, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, I want to thank you, God. Let's look in the book of Psalm 63, verse 1 to 2. Psalm 63, verse 1 to 2. This is David when he was in the wilderness of Judah. Oh God, you are my God. Early would I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you. In a dry and thirsty land where there is no water, so I have looked for you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. You see, this is David. David was praying, oh God, you are my God. Early would I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you. In a dry and thirsty land where there is no water, so I have looked for you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. To see the power. David was searching God in the sanctuary early in the morning. He seek God early in the morning. He seek God to see him because he is God. So I look for you in the sanctuary to see your power and glory. You can go to the sanctuary. You can go to the altar. You can go to the prayer, a prayer meeting where you are seeking the God, the power of God and the glory of God. You will go and seek the power of God and the glory of God. You know God is power. You know God has power. The power of God, the glory of God. You can just go to God. Since you are so dry, like David was thirsty, you don't know what to say. Say, God, I want to know your power and your glory. I want to know your power and your glory. You know God is a mysterious God. God is looking somebody who is ready to stand, who is ready to seek him, who is ready to confess his word. Confession is so powerful. It's so powerful. The devil does not want you to confess. He wants you to be negative. The devil wants you to be negative. The devil wants you to be sad and miserable. The devil does not want you to be happy. When he has blessed you, when you feel so much discouraged, when you feel like you want to give up, it is when he is very happy for you. But you will say, God, I feel like this, but I need to know your power and your glory. Yes, I'm seeking your power and glory. Lord, protect me. You promise your protection. Help me. Support me in this hour. Support me in this hour. God is faithful. God is mysterious. God is very faithful. You turn your negativity to the positive. You turn your negativity to positive. You turn your negativity to positive. You abandon every discouragement. You abandon every frustration. You abandon every power that you want to give up. Wrong decision. You give up wrong decision. You might decide very long. You might decide different. You might decide something which will make mistakes for the rest of your life. Because of simple, you obey, you are fresh. When you feel like I'm decided to give up and this is what I'm going to do, I've been praying, nothing I'm going to do. Now I'm going to go by myself. I go to the bar to look for anybody who will love me. You are so desperate. You say, I'm going to the world to join the group there to do my way. One person was giving a testimony. Somebody sent me a video of somebody was giving a testimony. This man, his mother died when he was young. And then the people did a mistake. They said, God has taken your mother. So this man was very angry with God. He said, God, why are you taking my mother and leave me motherless? Why are you taking my mother? And then the man said, God, I'm going to make you feel bad. I'm not going to do anything good for you because you are a bad God. You can't take my mother and leave me alone. Leave me and like this. So the man was very bitter with God. And then he broke the law. He was using gun. He was arrested. When he was arrested, and then he was taken to prison. Of course, if you kill somebody, you will also be killed, or you will go life sentence. Now in prison, he started feeling that he started fearing, and because in prison there is preachers preaching there. One man preached to him, and he felt that, yeah, I think I have to change my mind. I have to change my mind. Then he changed his mind. He gave his life to God, and he was sorry for God. And he said, God, you deliver me. I'm sorry. I was ignorant. Please, God, forgive me. I know you are really help me, deliver me from this place. Then I will serve you the rest of my life. And that's what God did. Now his judgment was, he was to be going to be killed, is to be going to be hung. Now, when he was called to the court, the church was wearing red to sentence him to death. Immediately at the courtroom, Jesus appeared there in that room. And then the man saw Jesus when the church was reading the churches. Jesus was standing there and the angels. And then something happened to the church. And then the church looked at this young man and says, you young man, you are young. You have not done your life anything. I'm going to release you. And then he asked the prosecutors, the lawyers, everybody in the court. He said, this is a young man. He has not done anything in his life. I'm not going to sentence him to death, but I'm going to give him the second chance. I've dismissed this case. Man, go free. Young man, go free. You are free. Now, because the police were there, who were going to take him to kill him, because his sentences was to be hanged. Now, the people who came to have him, they were there with the car, with the vehicle to take him to take him to the place where they hang people. Then when the church dismissed his charges, this man, and then Jesus came and hold the man. And then Jesus hold the man like he kissed him. Now, when the man got out, he didn't believe until sometimes he was found that he is out. Yeah? So God will deliver you no matter what is this. No matter when you are, you know, people are bitter with God for no reason, because of ignorance, because they don't know that God is a loving God. God, our God is so good God. Anytime you feel so bad, you feel things are not working, doing good, nothing is working for you, repent. Ask God, God, I'm so sorry. I am asking you, Lord, I'm really sincerely sorry for anything happening to me. Is it me? Is it my father's? Is this where does the door has opened from me? Which door has opened for me to go through this? Don't be bitter. Don't give up. Don't be discouraged. You know, sometimes it's not easy. It's hard. I know my daughter was facing very difficult life, very difficult time. She was not able to sleep. She was being really feeling frustrated, rejected, feeling hopeless, but she was battling this. She didn't want to share to anybody because she said, I'm not going to be begging. I'm not going to beg. I will not be begging. I'm tired. I need to do something. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You see, sometimes you might feel so low, so discouraged. You just say, let me come. Now, when she called me, she told me that is her position. I told her, that is nothing. That is nothing. That is nothing. I told her, that is nothing. You stand firm, you will receive the salvation of God. Yeah, yeah. The decision you have made, it is nothing. It is not going to happen. Okay? I talked to her. Now she started feeling good. She told me, Evrin, oh, yes, you are there. Yes, yes, thank you, my daughter, you are there. You know, you remember you didn't sleep. Even your eyes was... was hurting you, and in the morning you are going to work. You had that frustration and rejection, and you feel like hopeless. You feel like even throw those kids and leave and go away. Your own, yeah. This is the time you receive the salvation of God. You see God when you are so low, when you are almost to decide a wrong decision. That's when God will appear. And for sure, God is God. He will prepare your divine helper. He will support you and help you in Jesus' name. Yes, sometimes, yes, yes, it is true. Sometimes it looks very difficult. It looks very hard. But don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. I know it's not easy. Sometimes it's not really easy. My friend, my sister, and my daughter, Treasure, she can also agree with me. It's not his sometimes. It is so hard. Sometimes Treasure could call me and tell me, Mama Christine, it's so hard. I don't know what I will do. I've prayed. I've done everything, Mama Christine. And Mama Christine, please, I don't know. I don't know what to do. I always tell them, yes, 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 that's true. But keep on. Don't give up. Don't give up. Keep on. Yeah, God will appear to you. God will support you. God will help you. God will protect you from attacks. Yes. Sometimes you feel like you are the only one who is going through this, but God will help you. Look at what happened to the children of Israel. It was not easy for them. They were dead and life. They were facing death and life. But what happened? They encouraged themselves. They continue around in the place. In the midst of the enemies, the Bible says, in the midst of the enemies, God will prepare a table for you. In the midst of where you have no return, when you look at your bank account, nothing. You look at your relative, friends everywhere, nothing. So you are like 0 point. You have nowhere to turn to. Focus to God. He will appear to you. He will support you. He will protect you from every attacks of the enemy. Yes, you are alive. Thank God. You are alive. Thank God. He will come to you. He will support you and help you in the name of Jesus. You might see today is very hard, but tomorrow you will laugh. Tomorrow you will have that fellowship. You will be very happy and you will be loving in Jesus' name. Remember always to fellowship with God. Remember always to fellowship with God. When you have been thinking, when you have reached a point where you don't know anything to think anything, call God. Say, God, come. Let's fellowship with you. I want to fellowship with you. I want to know your power and your glory. Where is your power and your glory? I want to know your power and your glory. These two words, it is very important to the kingdom of heaven. It is very important to God, and God will come. God will provide that way. Treasure, we were talking yesterday, I was talking with her, and then I told her how God provides her. God has been using some strange ways of providing for her. She will never lack. We have our covenant we made with God. Overcomers has made a covenant. You will never poor to eat. You will never lucky. There is no day you will never be lucky. You will never poor. All the people who are partner with us, who are following our ministry, they can be my witness. Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, we believe we have made a covenant. We will never poor. We will never lucky. When you don't have anything, always God provides you. You don't have to worry. As long as you are faithful with your tithe and giving, and you are always obedient to God, you will never, never. That is our covenant. So if you want to join our partner, to become our partner, join us. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Plant a seed. Donate an amount. Become one of us. Become our partner. You don't have qualification to join us. You just join us as the way you are. You might have your church. We don't remove you from your church. You just be your church, but join us. Go to our website. Look at what we do. Join us. Call me for prayer and protection. I will pray for you, and God will protect you. Not me. I don't protect people. It is God through me. Through me. If you feel like you have been attacked by witchcraft, you need deliverance, you need you to move forward, call me. I will pray with you. I'm here to support you and pray with you. Our number is 905-792-3798. Our number is 905-792-3798. God will help you in Jesus' name. Go and plant a seed. An amount. We don't charge. Some people, they ask me, how much do you want us to give? How much do you want me to give? I said, if I ask you 1,000, would you be able to give me 1,000? Just give what you have. God knows. If you have 1,000, yes, give to 1,000. We need to help the children. We need to help single mothers. We need to help people who need help. We need to help youth, community, our community. If you feel you want to give 1,000, welcome. Give. We thank God. If you want to support me as a person, love offering, you love me so much, you want to support me, my personal support as a friend, you can support me. I can't refuse, because I love people who love me. I love people who appreciate me. So you are welcome. If you want to plant the ministry, you are welcome. You can write a check to Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. It will go to the account, the bank account, and nobody will touch that money. That money is accountability is there, and no one will steal your money. It will go to the work you want. You are welcome to call me and ask me my donation. What did it do? You can call me, or you can ask our accountant. They can talk to you. You can ask even Treasure. Right now, you can call Treasure and ask her what the money that we are giving. What does it do? She will explain to you. Okay, God is helping. God is good. We want to thank God and praise God that God is able to provide. And you know the enemy is a liar, and he will try to attack your finances, and then you feel like you have been giving and giving and giving, nothing's happening. That is not true. God is not a contradicting God. God is not a liar. He has said he will bless you, he will open windows of heaven and rebuke the devourer. As long as you know where you are giving, then God will bless you. You have to get connected. Where you give is where you get connected. You can give, but you are not being connected. Then your giving will be like zero. It's better you give where you are being connected. Yes? That is another thing you have to check. Wherever you give, are you connected with the ministry? Are you connected with your spiritual father? Are you connected with your spiritual mother? The place you are giving, you have to be having a divine connection, a divine helper. That's when it will work for you. Thank you very much. God bless you. I love you so much, and there's nothing I can do about it. You know I love you. That's why I have come. I force myself to come to you to talk to you, and God will help you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. I love you so much. And there's nothing I can do about it. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Bye.